What's happening, guys? JD at JD's Custom Buggies. Very happy today because we're going to take our first look at a completed number 45 Helix. We just got it done, got it wired, got the motor fired up last night, got it in. I just got done wiring. My head hurts a little bit, but that's okay. I feel accomplished, really happy with the results. So I'm going to show you a one-of-a-kind Helix because I believe this is pretty much the only one like this in the country. So let's have a first look. So we'll do a little bit of a walk around. We probably skipped a bunch of steps because the last we looked at it, she wasn't painted. She didn't have her panels on. She didn't have a motor in. So we got right to painting. We're in a bit of a crunch. We have about, literally 2 weeks from now, she'll be on the track racing. So I guess we'll start from back to front. So all the way around, we got A6, DWT A6 wheels, 10 inch, both front and rear. The offset on this is 4+1. I was trying to narrow it in a little bit and get it, just by the time we got the arms out and everything, we're trying to keep it around 5 feet wide, and it's about 5 feet, 2 inches. So we got GBC XC Masters front and rear, 22/7/10s on the front, 20/11/10 on the back. Whole front end is custom, built in house here. As you've seen through the videos, you pretty much have gone through this whole thing with us. Got 5/8 time joints for ball joints. We actually have a high 5/8 time joint for the outer tie rod end with a 1/2 inch bore. We made the clevises and whatnot in the tie rods here. The arms are made here. The rack is an MP rack, which are going up daily in price. It's getting crazy, but these are the racks that I've been using. At one time we could get it for $99, and now they are in excess. From what I see, they're up to $200. As far as shocks go, we found some Fox Podium shocks. They're from a Polaris Predator. We're using the front shocks for the from the Predator on both the front and the rear here. We did put some new wall balls bushings in them. They were in need of bushings, but the shocks were pretty much in great shape otherwise. I mean, obviously they're used, but other than that, they just needed a little bit of bushings in them. It was basically 3 out of the 4 shocks were in dire need, and the fourth one was okay. Put new bushing kits in those. As far as the steering, got a quick release, quick cars, basically a race car, quick release. Came with this nub for the kit. We incorporated into the steering shaft that we made here. Got a Pro Armor steering wheel. Gas pedals. Both pedals we went through in the last video were kind of custom made. Ben had come up with some non-skid matting or whatnot, so we put them on the pedals and on the floorboard. Not sticking so great on the floorboard, so we're probably going to redo it and maybe put a little 3M adhesive on there to see if they stick a little better. Went through the whole steering shaft here. We have a 1-inch bearing that basically pivots inside there. It's got a grease fitting. We got a 3/4-inch Heim joint for support bearing down at the bottom. The steering shaft completely comes apart, so if we ever need to replace pieces or, you know, we have an issue, we need to take it apart, we can take it apart. I don't like to make parts that are, like, permanently on there that, you know, if we have to replace that Heim joint, for instance, this will come apart, we can replace the Heim joint. If we have to replace the steering bearing in there, we can do that. So I like things that, you know, you can get parts and replace them. The seat's out of a Razor. Ben ended up buying a Razor seat and putting a cutout in it. It was orange at one point. We're trying out. There's a dye kit that one of the other racers had come up with and did his seat black. So we gave this a shot with that. We have Pro Armor seat harnesses in here. They're basically the passenger side seat harness from a Razor. You can find them on the website. Throttle rod kit. We actually installed that today and ended up using the install for a video for anybody who's bought a throttle rod kit, just to take some of the guesswork out of it. Coming back here is our one-of-a-kind swing arm, at least this is, you know, one off for me. It used to be a two-piece, it was an old hammerhead twister swing arm. He extended it 3 inches in the front and then put the Heim joint there, so that's greasable Heim fitting. I want to say it's got a 3/4 bore, and then it has reducer, like Heimis spacers that bring it down to a 1/2 inch. But it ended up working like a charm. We actually mounted the motor on the floor. We got it off the engine stand, mounted her up, and she dropped right into place. It didn't really take much effort to get the, we were worried about the bolt holes, you know, this part flexing or whatever. She went in fairly easy. So bolted in all the way around. Motor's done. It's got a 61 millimeter big bore kit in it, which is basically MBX rules. We're limited to 61. It's the way I wrote the rules to keep it affordable. In case there's anybody, you know, wants to build their own motors, as I'm a boring tool, just trying to keep the whole class kind of cheap. A14 cam, got our Mikuni carburetor. We actually have TFC clutching in this. We're trying that. So Dr. Pulley hit clutch, but the rest of the components are TFC. Got our Rattler exhaust. Trying to think if there's anything. I mean, motor's pretty much standard fare for 90% of the builds that I'm, you know, MBX. There's really nothing that's too much different. I'm running pretty much the same motor in the Yerf Dog. The other thing is, you know, our fuel tank and our, you know, basically a petcock. Like to put enough fuel line so as this thing's bouncing up and down. First MBX races, we had a couple of racers, you know, we went over a jump and the thing overextended and yanked the fuel line right out of the carburetor. And so we kind of learned that, you know, a little bit extra fuel line does not hurt. The other cool thing about this is we got a couple videos on our Banjing CDI coil combo. We've got to mount it down here. We just found some aluminum tread plate, made a plate right there, and we got it mounted right there. It's close enough to the head that everything should work. And then following up with the electrical, we just wired everything in-house. There's no harness or, you know, cutting up our harnesses. We do everything, include installing all the terminals. But the battery is in here. We have a WPS Firepower feather light. So, I mean, it's small enough and light enough. It fits right in the box. All the wiring comes to here. Opted to go without a key switch and try this. This is not something of mine. It's basically an Amazon thing. So I didn't want to wire up too much DC to it. The only thing I wired up is the light. And basically all these, the switch and the button are wired to ground. All the hots go straight to the hot on the solenoid. So the only thing I did is when you flip that up, that's just telling me to ignition's on and the CDI is on, the DC CDI. So basically, I'm not sure if I have fuel. Oh, we're out of gas. I had just enough gas in the carburetor. We fired it up in the shop. That light, we were scared by that for a second, but she turns off in a second. So yeah, I was hoping maybe enough fuel left in the bowl, but that doesn't have any fuel in it left. The only thing we have left to do is there's two issues that we had in the shop. One was we were looking for a Trailmaster rear brake line, and I don't know if it was a mispick or whatnot, but brake lines that last batch of brake lines that I ordered seemed to be 99 inches instead of the stock 75 inch length. So it was way too much brake line. We ended up going to Boneyard, just in case, we were feeling randy because we really want to start her up and just take it down the road. Sometime this week. So obviously Monday, today's Sunday, so Monday first thing I need to order some parts and let them know that I got the wrong brake lines and that I need the new brake lines pronto. The other thing is apparently I didn't realize I had sold out of the engine hangers. Pulled one off an old motor in the engine room and it has a little bit of a tweak in it. So we got it there just for mock-up purposes right now. So when I order the brake line, I'm going to order a new one, the new hanger, and get it on there. That's the last two parts. Once we get the brake line in, we'll probably end up bleeding the brakes just to run it up and down the road, make sure everything's stout, and then replace the brake lines when they come in. That is, I believe, everything. So that's all I got for you right now. Hopefully we're gonna see some good stuff out of this machine. I got my hopes. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. If you need parts, go to gotbuggies.com. Thank you guys. JD's out.